Well, I think there may not be one individual group who has been more supportive other than the stakeholders that were business folks that took the time to invest in the front end just to kind of, or donate, to be able to advance the concept to see if the concept had real viability, which it does. So that was obviously crucial to get it rolling. And as I've been connecting with the chamber and the realtors, the visitors bureau, and the stakeholders of the White River Watchers, and talked with the Delaware Indian Tribe folks, and I've met with the DNR, with the Mounds Park folks. We're not asking for anyone to rubber stamp. We're just asking people to have an open ear and kind of help us understand if this is a dynamic project. It has a lot of challenges to clear, and a lot of stakeholder positions. So those will be the unique pieces as we kind of advance the project forward to kind of continue to build a team. So. Well, we need to do a phase two study to investigate some additional data related to several points that are being asked across the board, from environmental to feasibility of infrastructure of the and impact to existing properties and those type of things. So I liken this, you're right, this is a long-term project. This will play out in months and years, not days and weeks. And it's going to be a project that takes a lot of community across this region, including in the Delaware County, support in order to advance it. So those are crucial components as we play. I also call this kind of a marathon with hurdles. So, you know, we're not doing a sprint. You've got to pace ourselves, and we certainly need to understand that at any given time we can trip over a hurdle that it will, you know, potentially end the project just simply because of the impact that it does. Yeah, I think that was my second question after the first one was, can this actually happen, when we were looking very early into this doing mapping. The second question is, what about the impacts of environmental impact? Out of the 2,100 acres, there's probably a couple hundred acres of developed area. And out of that, we know that some was used for landfill purposes in the 50s, 40s and 50s, and early 60s. Across the board, the environmental folks from several different firms that have looked at this have all concluded that those issues are not issues that are a fatal flaw, and that through normal processes of development of this project, those things will be taken in consideration. We have done an early set of well data polls in that area on some existing wells. When I say wells, they were where they were established for environmental purposes, and those draws are all clean and don't demonstrate anything in the lower water basin. The other consequence in the salvage yard operation, which at Rangeline happens to be one of the cleanest operations in the state, has been awarded some awards for its it has drained fuel and drained oils on vehicles since the 70s, way before anybody was mandatory required to do that. Anything on those grounds are migrating to the watershed anyway. So the idea that even if there is something there currently, which we believe that not to be an issue, but if it is there, it's still migrating to the same water pool. The only difference is it's a stream instead of, you know, 6 billion gallons in a lake. So we're feeling good. It's obviously a serious consideration to the broader scope of the project, and will be considered looked at really well in the second phase of some additional well sets.